Hello and welcome to Virtual Pond Dipping here at Rutland Water Nature Reserve with me, Jo, Education Officer for Anglian Water. Today we're going to be doing some pond dipping. I'll be scooping out nets full of creatures from our education pond and we'll be having a look at them in closer detail in some trays that we've set up on the tables. You can certainly try this at home if you have your own garden pond, but make sure that you have an adult with you supervising. You get down on one knee so you have a nice stable base. And if you have any fresh cuts or eczema on your hands, then you should wear some rubber gloves so you don't get the water into your cuts. This is a bloodworm. It's a type of midge larvae, but this is the only time in its life when it actually has teeth. When it turns into a little midge, it doesn't have teeth and will only live for a few days. This is a lesser water boatman, one of two types of water boatman that we get in the pond. It's called a water boatman because of its large oar-shaped legs that it uses to swim. We know this is a lesser water boatman because it swims on its front. This is a greater water boatman, slightly bigger than the lesser water boatman, and it swims on its back, always doing backstroke. The part you can see here is actually its stomach. On hot summer evenings, they will swim to the surface of the water, turn over, and then they fly between different ponds. This is a damselfly nymph. When it grows up, it will turn into a damselfly. They're very similar to dragonflies and are closely related. You can tell the difference when they're adults because the dragonflies tend to be larger and hold their wings open when at rest, whereas damselflies will always close their wings back along their bodies. This is a dragonfly nymph. This particular dragonfly nymph is from a broad-bodied chaser. We know this because of the shape of its body. Dragonfly nymphs can live in the pond for up to 5 years, and when they emerge as adult dragonflies, they will only live for one summer. This is a ramshorn snail. It's a type of water snail and spends its whole life living in the pond. They are herbivores eating the plants that live under the water. It's called a ramshorn snail because the shape of its shell resembles a ram's horn. This is a water beetle. We have many different species of water beetle that call our pond their home. This is one of the smaller ones. All the water beetles fly between different ponds on hot summer evenings, and they can swim up to the surface of the pond and take a bubble of air underneath their wing cases. Sometimes when they swim back under the water, you will see a bubble or two of air escape.